All right, just give me a second here. I'm just gonna share that I'm going live here just on a few social media platforms, and then we will get going. All right. All right, I just need to start my music here too. Forgot to plug in my phone here. Otherwise, it doesn't usually last. All right, let's see what we got going on here. Okay. So I got to change one of these. This is actually supposed to be dark, and that one's supposed to be that lighter color. So I'm going to mix a little bit of that lighter color to fill that in first, and then do the second layer on some of these ones here. They're looking not too bad. No, they need a second layer. And then do the dark all the way around.
Thank you.
just download my new podcast to listen to. Hey, Elaine. That's awesome. I'm glad you bought a wood burner. It's so much fun to do. You'll have to send me some of your stuff that you'll be doing. I'll have to check you out. Do you have an Instagram or anything that I could follow to keep track of what you're up to? Slogan. All right. Once I'm done here later this evening, I'll have to get on there and follow you. Then I can see what you're up to as well. Oh, nice. I was thinking about trying to do some. Oh, you haven't done any wood burning yet? That's okay. It takes some time to get into and mess around, but there's a lot I'm wanting to experiment with, but it's hard to find the time in between everything else that I need and want to do with that. I'm sure you can relate to that. But painting on wood is pretty satisfying too. I quite enjoy it. Acrylics, oils, and pastels. Wow. I've done just acrylics, a little bit of watercolor, wood burning stuff. I haven't done any oils, but I'm interested to try oils. Yeah, this is just acrylic paint. Lot of times I just use like Liquitex heavy body or gold and heavy body paint, acrylic paint. Yeah, I've seen, different types of animals doing kind of shapes inside, and I find it just a cool way to add a different look to it instead of just trying to, do realism or things like that. I haven't really done many like this kind of style with animals yet, but I'm looking to get into that. Bought some wood canvas panels. To be honest, I've never actually used wood canvas panels for wood burning. I have thought about it, but I usually just buy wood from like a hardware store, place where they have wood, and I just burn that kind of wood. I usually just, buy a long sheet of it and then just measure it and slice it all the way down with a saw. But I can't imagine why wood panels, like wood canvas panels, wouldn't work. They should work just fine. Oh yeah, on sale half off. I mean, why not try them? No problem. I mean, I may as well share how I kind of go through my process, right? It's I've learned from so many other artists that, in the last, I've been painting now for about 6 years, just over 6 years, and I've learned so much from other artists like Chuck Black and Will Kemp and so many others that, yeah, I mean, it's a pleasure for me to show my ways and hopefully help other people out and inspire other people too. Yeah, Chuck Black was the first one to kind of get me into doing re more realistic wildlife, and I did that for quite a bit, and done a few that I really like, and then kind of moved away from that, and I've started doing these wood ones for the last year, and yeah, I think I kind of found a little bit more my style, and it's I've been stuck on these ones for a while. I love it. Yeah, pastels. Yeah, I've heard they're pretty messy too, and I didn't know that you kind of once you're in, you can't erase it. But yeah, it's the same with wood burning. As soon as that line is burned in, there's no going back. Yeah, with paint you can just go over it as many times as you want to, really. And yeah, that's definitely nice in that sense, I guess. The different tips in the wood burning kit. Well, I guess it kind of depends on which wood burning kit you have. The first wood burning kit that I used was kind of one of those hobby ones. That had like kind of the I should just find it. I don't even remember where it is. I have that one put away somewhere. But they're like big, solid pieces that have, some of them have angular blade kind of blades on them. Other ones have kind of like almost like a screwdriver end on the end, like little squares. There were kind of larger circles for brands, a few different kinds. But with the new kit that I have, the one by True Art, I've done a product review video of that on my channel. It's a bit more expensive, but it's well worth it. For that one, the tips are all a lot smaller, and they're more wiry, I guess you could say. And the ones that I use the most kind of come up and then angle a little bit at the end, like kind of like that. And so it can, for me, if I'm holding a wood piece kind of down on my lap, it's more like holding a pen instead of ones that come just like straight out of the end of the wood burning tip. And then if you're at an angle, then the bottom of it will catch onto the wood. So what I'm doing, what I'm burning, these pieces like this, like all the smaller ones, like even got a small one here. Look at that, a replica, just a smaller one. So when I'm doing these smaller pieces, then I'll use just a finer tip just so I can get these lines a little bit finer. But then when I did the big one like this, then I used a fatter tip so I could get these lines to be a bit more bold. Otherwise, they would have just been too small on this one, and they wouldn't have been as significant. And there's a bunch of different tips in there. They're used for writing or for detail. Other ones have them, so you can, I don't know, I think I would want to use something like that for texture of feathers or something on animals. But when I'm just burning in lines, I usually always use the same tip. And honestly, out of that wood burning, the new wood burning kit that, well, it's not really new anymore. I think I got it in, when did I get that one? Last December, I think. So I guess, yeah, I guess I've had it for a year. But I only use a few different tips. But that's because I've been mainly just burning lines. If I was to get into more burning of different textures or, looking for different things like that, then I'm sure I would use different tips more often and do some more exploring with that. The Walnut Hollow creative bur I think I've seen that one online. I think they sell that one at Michael's. Are the tips on that one like big solid metal pieces? Are they two little wires that kind of go down into the wood burner itself? Oh, the wiring. Okay, yeah, that's what I use on this one right now. And I find the wires, I don't know on yours, one like they heat up a lot faster and they cool down a lot faster, which is nice. The other ones were like, yeah, like solid pieces of metal that you literally had like you had to screw into the thing, and that one didn't get as hot. And I wasn't able to control the temperature on the old one. I don't know if you can control the temperature on yours or not, but on this one, I've got a dial on the box that it attaches to, and I'm able to, yeah, control the temperature, which is pretty nice. Okay, yeah, it has a little box thing and pen different. Yeah, it sounds similar to what I have. Just show you quick, actually. I inspired you to buy it. That's awesome. Here's the one that I have. Let me adjust this light a little bit. So this is the one by, yeah, a company called True Art. In the they're based in, oh, I can't remember where, in Texas maybe. And so, yeah, here's the little pen. This is that's the tip I use to burn these lines in this piece here. So it's a little bit thicker than what I normally use. Actually, no, it's not a little bit. It definitely is thicker than the ones that I usually use. But this thing came with about 40 different tips in this box. Oh, dropped a little bag. But I'll show you the one that I usually use. That's the one that I usually use. You can see it has that little curve in it, and I like that because then when I can hold it, the pen at an angle like this, and then it's kind of straight down, if that makes sense. Then I don't have to hold it. Yeah, I got the good one. Yeah. Yeah, after I sold a couple of the wood ones using the cheaper, smaller one that I got, I thought I better get one that was worth it. And this one saves me a ton of time. It's been awesome. It's been probably I've been saying this for the last year since I bought this wood burning kit, but it's my favorite purchase that I've ever made for any of my art supplies. Every time I get to use it's exciting. It was worth every penny. Yeah, always got to start out with the student grade stuff. I mean, yeah, it was the first one that I did or something, and it was just something I wanted to try out. And once I knew it was something I wanted to pursue longer, and I was already starting to get a little bit of profit from it, then I thought, why not upgrade and get something more professional? Started with the acrylics, the 50-cent ones at Walmart. Yeah, the very first paint set I was at university. I don't know what got me to go try painting, but I went to Michael's That's, you know, that's the main art shop that we have in Canada. And yeah, I picked up a $7 set of paints that had like a bunch of different paints in it, you know, a bunch of different cheap acrylic paints, and then a $7 set of brushes that had a bunch of different brushes in it. I think a $2 set of little canvas panels, and that was the stuff that that got me going, and haven't looked back since. Whereabouts are you from, Elaine, if you don't mind me asking? Siberia. Okay. I've been to Wisconsin once, but it was in the summertime. But over there, there's a lot of, you're close to the Great Lakes, and there's a lot of other lakes around in that area, right? Kind of forested. Oh, and I hear what you're saying about some of those cheap brushes. I still use some of those cheap brushes all the time. And I've even bought like those cheap packs of 50 brushes just so I could get one brush out of it because I liked it so much. All the lakes are poisonous because of all the farm. Interesting. Probably like because of all the fertilizer and stuff that they're using or pesticides, right? I'm assuming. Yeah, that's too bad. The brush I've been using for these, I got from a friend because his mom was an artist, and when she passed away, he didn't know what to do with all of her art supplies. So then I was fortunate and he gave them all to me. And so when this one goes, I don't know what I'm going to do because I don't know where to find a replacement for it. I'll have to look if I can find this one anymore, but I think some of them are pretty old brushes. I said, don't take your dog in it or it will die. Holy cow. Oh yeah, that's too bad. There should be laws in place to, you know, help protect that, you would think, eh? Yeah, no problem. On Instagram, I think it's just Brian Sloan Art. Yeah, I'm in Canada. I'm over in Alberta, so right north of Montana. Yeah, we're even in more northern Siberia. Yeah, we still have snow from the beginning of November. We got a huge dump in the beginning of November, and it snowed like a probably 2.5 to 3 feet, and that still hasn't melted away yet. Oh, in September. We were fortunate. We didn't get any in September. Usually we do get a little bit, but no, not this year. They were saved it all for November. Yeah, it might not melt till May. I mean, some of it here in southern Alberta, we get the Chinook winds, those warm winds that come through. And so usually a couple times in the winter, those will come through and melt it all away, which is nice. But this one, we haven't got it all gone yet. Just about. Yeah, I don't know in Fahrenheit, but we were in the positives today, which would have been, I mean, above 32 Fahrenheit, because 32 I think is freezing, right? And so we got above, probably we probably got to around 40 today actually as well. But then yeah, the next 2 weeks we're supposed to get some pretty cold, negative 13, negative 14s. Which in Fahrenheit would probably be more around, you know, like 20-ish or something. 20-ish, 15-ish. Yeah, it'll be cold here. Must be some cold block that's coming down, you know, and hitting all of us. Yeah, we're just north of Montana. Seriously, I heard this winter was supposed to be bad compared to other ones, so we'll have to see how it goes. Nope, not any pets. I had some growing up, but since I've moved out and started my own family, then no pets yet. Maybe one day we'll get a dog. Oh, coat and a boots on. Yeah, I believe in animals. You know, it's this is even really cold for them too. You're an empty nester. No, I've just got a little girl. She's still under a year old, so we've got our hands full with her. That's what people keep on telling me. Yeah, I've considered changing the look of the sky and doing instead of just a blue sky, doing kind of like a sunset scene, like you're saying there were some oranges or pinks. With this one, I can't because this one's a commission piece, so they want it like the other ones, you know, just with the blue sky. But I did one. I did some on when was it? Back in August, I think. And some people asked, they were three other commission pieces, but they wanted like a darker sky. So instead of these lighter blues, I did some navy blues and some grayish white clouds instead. And so that was a little bit different. But yeah, I've been wanting to try some more sunrise sunset looks and kind of change things up a little bit. In terms of the sky, and maybe even change the texture of the sky a little bit, because now this is just kind of like daytime clouds and stuff, but maybe have it be more of like a flowing in the background and changing it that way. I've got about three other designs burned into wood right now that I just haven't had time to get to, but I've got more of these designs that I'm wanting to put out, and a few that are still on the drawing board, still getting a few touches added to them to make them a little bit just more how I want them, I guess. But yeah, it's been fun to create like this. The new designs aren't commissions yet. They're just ones that I've been messing around with. I'll grab a couple here. Here's one of another lake up in Jasper National Park that I've been working on. And one of a barn scene that I've got going here. And then I've done one of Lake Louise before, but this is going to be a new Lake Louise. The granary, so this one's going to be like a bright turquoise. This one's a red, and this one's a whitish, creamish, I guess I should say, with brown. This one has brown roofing on it. This one has orange roofing on it, and this one has gray roofing on it. The ground is filled with yellows and oranges and kind of burnt oranges, burnt yellows, that kind of stuff, to be like a wheat field, you know. Yeah, this one has been one of my most popular designs that I do. I've done quite a few of these. Never one this big though. This is the first time I've done one this size. Yeah, the mountains do get crazy with color, but they're fun to do. I always find the colors change a little bit every single time, just slightly, but that's kind of the fun of it. This one's 20 by 30 inches. Here's one of my 16 by 20 canvases to compare it to. So you can see there, yeah, kind of how much bigger it is. Takes a lot of paint. Thanks. The buffalo is one of my favorites. I did that one, I think, in the springtime of this year. That's when I did those ones. For this one, or for the buffalo? Oh, what is it? It's just pine. Pine, I can't remember what, just knotty pine, I think it was. The smaller boards that I usually do are just knotty pine. This one, the bigger one, it had to get like some project wood. I got it just from Home Depot, and it looks like it's just some pine just kind of pieced together almost. But it's doing the trick. It has a little bit more texture to it behind than the smaller pieces do, but does it matter on the wood? I don't think it does. Obviously, if you're using darker woods, then something like a white is going to take a lot more than just two layers. I usually just use two layers of these colors, and then that's good, and the wood color doesn't show through as much. But if you're using a darker wood, then you're going to need more layers. I probably could even use a lighter wood. I could try birch or something. I don't know if that would change the burning habits of it at all, but I've just kind of went with pine right now because it's cheaper, to be honest, and it seems to work well for what I'm doing, so that's just what I've stuck with right now. I haven't tried staining, but I've seen some cool artworks with different types of stains that people have used, and just using different colors of stains instead of paint. And that would be something cool to try too, I think. Yeah, I could use resin. I wish resin was a lot cheaper. I haven't gotten into resin yet just because it's so expensive. I just use a gloss spray varnish on these wood ones, and it does a good job, but I think resin would be a nice touch too. But yeah, the glow, the spray that I put on these ones leaves them nice and uniform looking, and they're nice and shiny, kind of just like resin would be too, but it's working for now. It's just this stuff that I use. Bring it up closer. And it, yeah, seals, protects it, non-yellowing, that kind of stuff. I've seen a few other artists use that on wood, and so that's what I've been using, and it's been good. All right, well, I think I'm going to call it a night here, have a little bit of relaxed time before I gotta go to bed and get up for work tomorrow. Oh, that's lucky. Well, I'll be streaming again tomorrow evening, filling in a lot of the rest of this. If you want to join in tomorrow evening, and we can chat some more. It was nice talking to you, and it's always nice to talk to other artists and hear about their experiences. And yeah, so have a great night, and have a good vacation day tomorrow. I should be on probably 7:30 my time, Mountain Standard Time. And so I think you're just an hour ahead, so probably 8:30 your time. That's usually when I try to get on, is about 7:30. Yeah, so probably 8:30 Central Time. All right, see ya.